Today I want to talk about the Staffordshire Bull Terrier. In this case, not the working strains, but the show strains. Normal Staffordshire Bull Terrier, which was once a working dog, was the Bull Terrier, but has since then developed into a show dog. Romantic, they'll tell you. They kept the best of both worlds. They kept the dog that is able to fight and is as brave as the original dog, but is now also more suitable and easygoing because it only fights when provoked and will never start at itself but only end it. Dogs like these are often described with the Staffordshire Bull Terrier. In my opinion, there has been quite a lot of changes. Even show a Staffordshire Bull Terrier, when they changed the standard, they cut back almost 10 centimeters of the head to withers, but kept the same weight, which would give you a dog that's a lot more exaggerated. And this has led to the current Staffordshire Bull Terrier of show lines more resembles a cross between the original Staffordshire Bull Terrier and the Bulldog. So that's the thing, and even the show standards where they began at, of course they were closely or more close resembling that of the working dog, the fighting line, but in the pit it doesn't matter how your dog looks as long as he performs. So of course there is a optimal shape to be the all-rounder that you want, and to have for example both power, flexibility and also dexterity. So picked up his number two, so to be able to go the long run, of course, but even then a very solid build dog that was a quick finisher could win, and a dog that was less powerful but able to withstand a long fight could also win. And that made quite a range of types. With all pros and cons. Goedemorgen. Oh, niet op de fiets. Oké. Met baasje toe, hè? Hoi, hoi. And this is a good thing, that you have some diversity. Instead of just breeding a few. And then when one dog is winning shows, breed that dog. Because they were not tested anymore on performance characteristics, just looking tough and solid. And you see what this has done to the English Bulldog. The English Bulldog of old looked more like a Staffordshire Bull Terrier, being the modern, but even more so the old Staffordshire Bull Terrier, the original Bull Terrier, than the Bulldogs of today. And yeah, similar traits have been applied to the Staffordshire Bull Terrier as a show breed as well. Also, they bred African lines. I thought, what is this? Shorter backs, shorter noses, even more exaggeration. These were the first American bullies, but then African bullies. And also, if you have a South African line, South Africa is extremely hot. And then they said, yeah, they were the best fighters. What the hell? cannot be the case. South Africa is extremely hot. If you then have a very solid, small frame with a very short nose, then this will not happen. Perhaps I had like some French bulldogs and they wanted to give them a better time and bred in some Staffordshire Bull Terrier. And then sold them as South African lions, but this is just exaggeration upon exaggeration, and the breed suffers. Like that the American bullies will often have so much power compared to a little joint surface that they have troubles with the joints, or they rupture part of their muscles in the back legs, or something else happens. It is a monstrosity, not functional at all. And also the dogs now are very easy with other dogs, some of show lines. Some still can put up a tantrum, of course, but it's different than the pit dogs. And not all pit dogs have to be extremely dog aggressive, but of course they were bred to engage each other in the pit, and if they didn't, they would lose. So you can imagine that there's a different kind of aggression often there. But if you breed out the dog aggression, there was a time that when those dogs were in the pit, they had some specific characteristics, of course. They were extremely human friendly, because if they would bite under that dire circumstances, being shredded by an opponent, their own handler, often their own boss, or the handler of the opponent, or the referee, they would be disqualified. So even under that enormous pressure, they wouldn't give in normally to human aggression. But these traits have often been genetically intertwined, extensive line breeding and all the other stuff to make this happen, because it's quite unnatural to engage and be game and also go against that opponent, even if it means you're going to destroy yourself. This is not natural. A wolf would normally not do this. And also, if someone is there mocking you, you're already in pain. Goedemorgen. Je luistert goed. Ik zag hem met je vrouw of vriendin lopen en in het veld. Echt leuk.
Oké, okay, ja.
Ook met een maiskolf in haar bek.
Ja, dat doet ze graag. Ja. Ja,
heel mooi. Fijne dag om nog werken. Groetjes. En take out one equation, they say, yeah, we further refined the breed, we kept all the gameness and fighting abilities, and we just removed the dog aggressiveness. Are you sure? Because that gameness and the human friendliness, especially, that made it an extremely nice dog also for families. I'm not saying that every pit dog is a good dog for families, of course not. But they were extremely human friendly. And also in the past, they even threw them sometimes into that the parts where the small children were. They even called it the nanny dog. But I'm not advocating to keep your dog unsupervised with your children, but in the past they were extremely, extremely reliable dogs. And that's one of the reasons, next to the additional health and performance possibilities, that I went for a working strain, Irish bred, so to say, Staffordshire Bull Terrier. So you keep all the advantages, nice dog. Also with an on and off switch, it can be very enthusiastic and rambunctious, but also quite docile and relaxed, but also add to that even more human friendliness, more performance powers, better health, and that's something to keep into consideration. The dog on the leash here is no Staffordshire Bull Terrier. As you can see, it's a lot less bulky, even as compared to an Irish strain. This is a Patterdale Terrier, so a terrier to go underground against fox and badger. But you can also see here that there is some outline of a functional dog, even if it has to engage dogs or quarry in this case. So it has to fight off badger and fox in a narrow space. And then, even then, you don't need that boxy shape. You don't need it. It's just detrimental. All that weight of a powerful head is of course nice, but also those chests of that current Staffordshire Bull Terriers are like barrel shaped. You all see this in the English Bull Terrier. Non-functional. This is the kind of chest that you want. And this is not a dog bred to perform at a specific weight. It's a dog bred to perform at a specific chest circumference, if you want to say something. It's not that if it was a little bit bigger or smaller that it could not compete. Of course it could. The smaller ones could enter almost any den, and the bigger ones, they needed to help them a little bit more, or the dog does it himself. It takes just a little bit more time, but once there, the bigger dog has a better chance of dispatching or stopping the quarry as the smaller dog has. So all being said and done, there are benefits for both. But if it was bred for a certain characteristic, it was as much power as possible for this chest circumference, because it has to be able to enter the dens. Whereas the Bull and Terrier, so the ancestor of the Staffordshire Bull Terrier, was performed, was a weight performer. And they looked at the weight and they said, okay, we make a fixed weight, and then those two opponents would be matched after conditioning for a period. And if the dog didn't make the weight, was overweight, it should pay forfeit, or sometimes even the match was cancelled and already won by the opponent. So it gives you a different insight. But if you look now at that show Staffordshire Bull Terriers, especially in the show condition, if you pit it against a dog bred to perform in the pit, you would get a dog that is like 10-15 centimeters higher at the withers. And you can all imagine what would happen, because that bigger dog has superior wrestling power, superior stamina, superior length of teeth and strength also in the jaws. But this is just a silly thing to me. I'm not bashing someone who has a Staffordshire Bull Terrier. I think still, as a show breed, it's one of the best, and it brings a lot of advantages. Also so much better as compared to the Bulldog or Boston Terrier, if you like. And the funny thing is about the Staffordshire Bull Terrier is that you get quite a big dog in a small package. If it's a performance bred one or a show bred one, this doesn't differ that much, because both bring quite a lot. In my opinion, the performance will always be the better choice, but this is also regardless of breed, but especially in these type of Bull and Terrier type of breeds. Even this little guy, this is a Patterdale Terrier, brings a lot of dog for its size. So it's a small dog, yes, of course, but it brings a lot of dog. You cannot imagine how much dog it brings until you've seen one up close and personal, or especially experienced one in some conditions. You can really see what it is and what it does. Looks like it. So I hope you like this video. I will also do a video on the Irish strains after a while, and have a nice day. Bye bye.